I am Harshit and I welcome you all to this new series on No Coder Building a SaaS Application Using AI. And this is going to be an episodic series. But before that, I want to thank you all because we've just reached 1,000 subscribers. And that's actually a huge milestone for me because I've been doing YouTube since 2018. It was very on and off, but I think I kind of found my niche because if I show you guys the traction, we've got around 171 subscribers in just 28 days. And I've just been posting consistently about AI videos. And this was a video request from one of my viewers where they wanted to see a proper SaaS application built from scratch. So that's what the entire series is about. So let's dive into the first episode because this is actually the first episode. It's called the Genesis, right? So No Coder Building an AI SaaS and episode one, Genesis. So just to give you a small intro about this, this series is actually something which I really wanted to build because I have been building my own SaaS applications, but then all of that was not documented. And this is going to be a documented journey because I haven't built the product yet. And I will be building the product from scratch. And in this episode one in Genesis, I'll just give you like a small walk around of what the series is going to be about and what exactly can you expect from these series and what are we even going to build in the end, right? So just to give you a small point here, I'm going to be the creator behind app.harshit.io. More on that later. That's something that we're going to build. It's going to be a proper SaaS application. And my vision is to reach 100,000 subscribers by the end of 2025. So this series is actually, designed to inspire and empower non-coders to create sophisticated software solutions without traditional programming experience because I am a complete non-coder. Everyone used to say, you need AI, you need skills, you have to be an engineer to do this. AI isn't there yet. And even on my YouTube channel, I get a lot of hate saying, you can't build an AI application. You can't build a SaaS application, a full stack SaaS application with just AI. And I'm here to prove you all wrong. And also at the same time, also to inspire you guys that we can build this. All right. So if you just look into the comment that we got, so one of the person, one of my subscribers has just told me, congrats on the milestone. Please make a complete SaaS using AI. So that's what they want to do. And I think in another comment, they also mentioned that it'll be great to have a complete series, a whole series. And this is what it is. Like I said, again, this is Genesis 1, where we're going to do a small overview of the series, right? All right, so now let's look into the overview of the series. Here, I'm going to be doing, a small episode breakdown. So what you can expect in each of the episode and also my philosophy behind building the dashboard or, the SaaS that I'm building and why am I even building it? What's my goal with it and all of that, right? So the first, the first episode, which is the current episode, it's a small introduction, my vision and the whole non-coder concept as well, right? Episode two is going to be about ideation. So brainstorming and validating the SaaS idea using AI tools. We're also going to validate my SaaS idea as well and see if it's even worth it to build, right? Now design. So for design, we're going to be using v0.dev and we'll be creating amazing UI and UX using ShadCN UI because it's also integrated into v0 as well. And also Next.js because that's the, that's the language that we're going to use. And again, I might sound like I know how to code. I do not know how to code. All I know is, but I'm really, really good at prompting. I've been prompting since 2 years, meaning I've been prompting since the day OpenAI was released in November 2022. So I have a lot of prompting experience and that is what I'm going to, leverage. And now episode three, again, which was UI UX, and episode four is going to be the actual building process, developing the backend, and we can actually develop backend also with v0 as well. And then again, Cursor. Cursor is the go-to application for building any products. And we already have Cursor downloaded here. And that's exactly what we're going to use to build this. All right. And then episode five is going to be testing. We have to test. We have to implement QA testing process, maybe even get some of my subscribers on board to do beta testing to see if this platform is fully functional. Right. And then six is going to be launch. we're going to launch this on Product Hunt. So episode 6 is going to be great because once we build the entire application, we're also going to launch this on Product Hunt. So if you guys don't know, Product Hunt is where a lot of, you know, products are being launched on a daily basis. Micro SaaS applications are being launched. Even some of the biggest applications like YC 400 application, they also launch on Product Hunt, you know, to get some traction as well. So we're going to launch it on Product Hunt. And then episode 7 is going to be market. So how are we going to market? Because I come from a marketing background and that was my strength, right? That was my strength. Email marketing, newsletters, creating content, even podcasts. All of these are my strength. And I'll be sharing with you guys how we can do that as well. And then monetize. So what's the point of building a SaaS when you're not able to make revenue, right? So that's when we'll be monetizing it. And I'm also going to tell you how we're going to do all of that in this video itself, in this episode itself. Just a couple minutes. And scale, how are we going to scale this, you know, scale the application? But I'm honestly really not sure as well. In my head, I mean, I've created these episodes, but all I know right now is only till this episode. I've only prepared myself only for episode 1, so I don't want to bombard myself, you know, with all of these. I just want to go slow. I just want to go take it slow, take it step by step, only focus on the first episode, and then we go to the next and the next one, all right? And then after scaling, of course, beyond is going to be maintaining it, getting users on board, you know, taking more feedback and all of that, all right? So now let's look at the whole concept of it and why even me? Why am I even building this, all right? So why non-coder? The thing is, I am a non-coder. I come from a marketing background, but I can still build applications, man. I think AI has gotten so good. Clouds on it has gotten so good that you can build applications. All you need is $20 a month subscription for V0, for Cursor, and for Cloud. Maybe not Cloud because you already get that on Cursor.com, but you need these subscriptions. All you need is, let's say, $100, that's all. $100 a month, that's all for subscriptions, and you can build it. All right? So why me, right? Because I've actually exited my own AI SaaS startup, which is called Artifin Inc. And it was acquired by a San Francisco-based private equity firm, which is called OSS Ventures. And they were really, you know, really nice people. They want to talk to me and they wanted to acquire Artifin. And this was, you know, a small tweet that I posted. It was actually acquired on acquire.com. You can actually go look at this tweet as well. It was one of the biggest acquisitions for me. It would definitely, you know, gave me a lot of liquidity to experiment with a lot more. So that's why I'm creating content right now, because I've done something, I have the knowledge, so why not double down on it and then repeat it again, right? So now, what is the vision for the series, right? So the vision for the series is basically, I'm inspired by school.com. So if you guys know what school.com is, school.com is basically a creator-centric platform where creators or YouTubers, you know, they can create their own communities. For example, this is Wi-Fi Life. It's his own community where members are joining in. They're getting more exclusive content. And that's what I've been, you know, focusing on a lot. And there's another one, which is AI Agency Incubator. So there are like 2.8K members in this one. And I think most of these are free, but there are a lot of paid communities as well, because I've seen one by David Ondridge. He's also a really good creator as well. Yes, David Ondridge. I think it's called The New Society. Yes, The New Society. And it's a paid membership. It's $97 a month. And that's how creators are empowering itself. I mean, to honestly say it, it's basically like OnlyFans, but for creators who have real value add, right? So that's what it basically is. And once you enter this, you get all these benefits and all that. So that's something exactly I want to build for myself, for my own community as well. Now let's dive deeper, right? So the objective is, of course, it's going to be to demonstrate AI development. You can be anybody sitting anywhere in the world. Or if you're just watching this video, if you use these skill set, if you watch these series completely, you can build your own SaaS application. This is basically to empower non-coders, because as a non-coder myself, when there was, you know, no ChatGPT, I was like super intimidated by all these coders, because one thing I know is developers, they have shit ideas. They don't have understanding of the world, but they can build. I had the understanding of the world. I had the business acumen, but I couldn't build. But now it just changes everything. All you need I mean, what can I tell you? I mean, you're combining these superpowers and then you're able to build it by yourself. And guys, if you're not able to get rich in 2025, then what's the point? Because we have all the tools, man. I know it's possible to do that. So, you know, let's just focus on that. That's my personal goal as well. So, you know, I think it should be your personal goal as well. Should very, very important to do that because the world's changing rapidly and, you know, we have to safeguard ourselves from everything. All right. So achieve scalability, a couple of pointers there. If you also, I'll be dropping in the entire, the entire document so that you can dive deeper and read into it. And now let's get into the dashboard itself. So the community dashboard project. So it's going to be for exclusive content sharing, private community, and email integration as well. And then monetization option for me, where I'll be monetizing this with a paid membership. I'm not really sure on the paid membership yet, but this again would be in the episode 2, where we'll be doing more of the brainstorming on the actual product idea, trying to validate this more on Reddit and all of that. But for now, this is actually the rough idea that I have to build my own community where you guys come in. You guys ask me questions. We learn. There are more courses that I post. And again, this entire course is also going to be again live in our dashboard as well. So that is what I want to build. But of course, it will be having all these options. Calendar option, classroom, members, leaderboard, and I think we can, you know, still brainstorm on more of these features. Maybe I'll be also be taking a lot more, inputs from you guys as well. And then maybe I can do a better one, right? So that's what I want to do. And that's basically my goal here. And now let's get into the philosophy. Like, what's the key philosophy behind me even doing this? Like I said, it's so hard to get VC funding. That's what I've seen. It's just so hard to get VC funding. And if you really want to build something when you don't have the kind of connections that most people have in SF, your only leverage is having personal brand. When you have a personal brand for yourself, people know you as you and they're willing to take a bet on you. And that's what I want to build. And like Naval Ravikant's four forms of leverage, which are labor, capital, code, and media, are central to our strategy here. Because in our case, we're primarily leveraging code, which is through AI tools, and media through YouTube to maximize my impact and efficiency. So what is code, right? Code is basically utilizing AI-driven development tools to build and maintain a SaaS application without traditional coding. And media, leveraging my YouTube channel to reach and engage a wider audience, promoting the series and the platform simultaneously. I mean, imagine, right? I'm also creating this and also I'm kind of promoting my own platform as well, right? So that's what I'm really, it's a meta thing to say. I mean, you're doing both simultaneously. And this is something that I want you to look at. So this is actually a diagram by Visualize Value by Jack Butcher. So this is what traditional people do. They build and they sell. They build again and then sell. So this is basically like traditional businesses, right? You build a good and then you sell that good. You build a second one and you build another one. So it's basically like traditional business. But what we're doing here is digital business, where you build only once, but then you sell it to multiple people, right? You basically just build once and you sell it to multiple people. And that is what leverage is. And another concept by Kevin Kelly, he wrote this article in 2008 called 100,000 True Fans. So all you need is just 1,000 True Fans to live independently and make $100,000 per year, all right? So imagine if you keep the $100 of each True Fan, you essentially need only 1,000 of them to earn you $100,000 per year. I mean, I know it's kind of like I'm building this platform and I'm just selling it to you guys itself. But I really think there is value in this, man, because the kind of value I'll be able to provide, and because I have this a lot of, you know, knowledge by myself as well. I'm learning so much from, talking to everybody. I'm also consulting at a YC funded startup. I'm just learning so much. And why just, you know, why? I mean, if you're good at something, never do it for free, right? Joker says that in Batman, right? I mean, if you have the skill, make sure you monetize it. And that's exactly what I want to do. I want to monetize my skill using this dashboard, right? So this is another philosophy and create a monetization, like I said. Also, I want ownership. Let's say I can just simply build on school, right? I can just do that. I can just go have my own community. I think I also have his own community called Micro SaaS, which I just started like a couple months ago, but never really took off, right? It's been almost an year since I started this, but never really took off. It just didn't land anywhere, nothing. So I had to pay like $100 a month for this, but what if they decide to ban me, right? School can always decide to just ban me or just do anything. They can just, you know, remove me like that. But if it's my own platform, nobody can do that. It's my platform. I have complete control over it. And now also email marketing and other monetization strategies. Basically, when I get users on board onto my dashboard, that means I also get their email addresses. That means I'm basically kind of owning my own community. It's like I'm trying to build my own tribe. And what happens when I get those emails? I mean, of course, I wouldn't, you know, be just using them or just spamming them. But I can give them an option to opt in to email newsletters. And now what happens when they're also reading my email newsletters? People would want to sponsor me to read those newsletters as well. So I think, you know, there are a lot of things that we can do. I think monetization becomes, I think there are so many ways to monetize once you get to a certain amount of audience. Right now, we just have 1,026 audience. Let this reload, maybe a little more. Yeah, just one more subscriber. Yeah, okay. I just got a bad comment saying, by Indian accent may be English bowl. Yeah. I don't know what it is, man. I don't know what it is about the accent. Most people just don't like my accent, or they just say Indian accent may bowl. I don't know, man. This is what it is. This is how I talk. This is how I'm going to talk. I don't give a shit. I don't give a fuck about what you guys think, because the good ones, the right ones will stick. They are the ones I'm after. That's the one. Also, one thing that I didn't mention here is I am seeking a community myself, because I live alone with my parents. I'm 22. Don't have a lot of friends. I have only one really good friend. He lives abroad. We talk, you know, we talk often. But again, this whole sense of community, right? Like, I'm looking for these like-minded people who want to build with me, man. I mean, just do shit, man. I mean, it's like, just do stuff. Just sit down, build. Make some money, create wealth for themselves. Even create generation wealth for themselves. That's what I want to do. That's what I want to build. And I know it's possible. But again, it just takes so much work. And I'm sure I was kind of procrastinating on, you know, doing the YouTube, because I never found traction while doing YouTube. So I thought maybe it wasn't for me. But I think I kind of found my niche, which is AI automation. And because I also have my experience is in Web3, and then it became AI, I think I know the space. So I think we can do this, man. This is basically a gist. So thanks for watching episode 1 in the series of No Coder Building AI SaaS Application Using AI. So the episode 1, which is Genesis. Thank you all for, you know, watching and just sticking around and understanding what my whole point of view is. And also, I'll be making these links live so that you can just watch, you know, read through the Notion document as well. But once we finish the entire course, even this document would be integrated inside the dashboard itself. So not everyone would be getting access to it anymore. It'll only be my community members. So that's what I'm doing. So yeah, the next episode would be about validating this the idea. If this is even a good idea as well. There's a lot of things that we have to do. A little bit more research, I guess. Scrape through Reddit. But that's going to be the episode 2 in this series. I know this wasn't really code heavy or building heavy, but again, before building, you have to get your mind clear. You have to get your mind clear on what is it that you want to build. And that's what we did in this Genesis episode. And again, thanks again for watching, guys. Stay tuned for the entire series. We are going to build the kick-ass community for Harshad Wadiparthi, where you guys can join, learn with me, and earn, and, you know, let's earn money using AI. That's going to be our goal. Let's use these tools to earn a living using AI tools. So that's all for today. See you guys in the next episode.